नमस्ते, खुश रहो बेटिया। आई जे वी एन डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार जैन, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। इज द फर्स्ट वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी इन द राजस्थान। टुडेज टॉपिक इज हाइपरटेंशन। हाइपरटेंशन आल्सो नोन एज हाई ब्लड प्रेशर इज ए लॉन्ग टर्म मेडिकल कंडीशन इन विच द ब्लड प्रेशर इन द आर्टरी इज presently elevated. The type of hypertension: pre-hypertension, systolic blood pressure is 120 to 139 mmHg, where dystolic blood pressure 80 to 89 mmHg, where hypertension stage first, systolic blood pressure 140 to 159 mmHg, or diastolic blood pressure 90 to 99 mmHg. Hypertension stage second, systolic blood pressure more or equal to 160 mmHg, diastolic blood pressure more or equal to 100 mmHg. Pregnancy including hypertension because of increased production of the hormones and enzyme during pregnancy. Etiology: the primary hypertension, it is in the elevation in BP without an identified cause. Secondary hypertension is the elevation in BP within the exact cause. This type is account for 5 to 10% of total cases. The cause of secondary hypertension include congenital narrowing of aorta, renal disease, endocrine disorder like Cushing syndrome, neurological disorder like brain tumor and head injury, sleep apnea, medication like oral contraceptive pills, NSAID, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug and cocaine, where cirrhosis of liver. The risk factor: age, chance of CAD after 50 years of age, alcohol, smoking or diabetes mellitus, excessive dietary intake of sodium, gender, family history, obesity, sedentary of lifestyle or stress. Pathophysiology: the normal blood pressure is maintained by four mechanisms: sympathetic nervous system activities, activity of vascular endothelium, activities of renal system, activities of endocrine system. Sympathetic nervous system activities: when the BP is decreasing, the activation of SNS will occur, central nervous system will occur. The increase of SNS activity increase the heart rate and cardiac contraction. Increase the heart rate and cardiac contraction produce vasoconstriction in the peripheral arterioles and promote the release of renin from kidney. The net effect of SNS activation is to increase the arterial blood pressure by increasing cardiac output and systemic vascular resistance. The vascular endothelium is single cell layer and the lining of the blood pressure. It will produce vasoactive substance and growth factor like nitric acid or endothelium, etc. These substances are potent vasoconstrictors and cause increased blood pressure level. Activation of endocrine system: when the angiotensin second is stimulated and the adrenal cortex, it will secrete aldosterone. The aldosterone will stimulate the kidney or retain sodium and water. Those the BP and cardiac output will get increased. Clinical features: sometimes the high blood pressure does not cause any symptoms, so that is known as silent killer disease. In some patient, the symptom will help like severe headache, blur vision, dizziness, nausea, vomiting, fatigue, confusion, chest pain, shortness of breath, irregular heartbeat, or papilledema. डायग्नोसिक इवोल्यूशन हिस्ट्री कलेक्शन एंड फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन मेडिकल हिस्ट्री ऑफ डायबिटीज मेलिटस कंप्लीट ब्लड काउंट चेस्ट एक्सरे या ईसीजी ईसीजी फुल फॉर्म इज इलेक्ट्रोकार्डियोग्राम मैनेजमेंट मेनली द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन इज पॉसिबल बाय टू वेज विच इंक्लूड लाइफस्टाइल मॉडिफिकेशन बाय फार्माकोलॉजिकल थेरेपी लाइफस्टाइल मॉडिफिकेशन द लाइफस्टाइल मॉडिफिकेशन मेजर मेनली इंक्लूड वेट रिडक्शन डाइटरी अप्रोच टू स्टॉप हाइपरटेंशन डाइटरी सोडियम रिडक्शन या रिड्यूस अल्कोहल एक्सरसाइज व स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट फार्माकोलॉजिकल थेरेपी वेरियस ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग आर यूज फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन कलेक्टिवली दीज ड्रग्स आर कॉल्ड एज एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव ड्रग विच इंक्लूड डायुरेटिक इट हेल्प द किडनी टू इनहिबिट द सोडियम रीअब्जॉर्प्शन इन द डिस्टल कन्वर्टेड ट्यूबुल्स असेंडिंग लिम्स एंड लूप ऑफ हैनले एग्जाम्पल के लिए क्लोरोथाइजाइन व फ्यूरोसोमाइड फ्यूरोसोमाइड व क्लोरोथाइजाइन बीटा ब्लॉकर्स दिस मेडिकेशन रिड्यूस द वर्ल्ड वर्कलोड ऑफ द हार्ट एंड ब्लड वेसल्स एंड कॉजिंग द हार्ट टू बीट स्लो एंड विथ लेस फोर्स एटिनोनॉल व प्रोपेनोनॉल अल्फा ब्लॉकर्स दिस मेडिकेशन कॉज द पेरिफेरल वैसोडाइलेशन ऑफ ब्लड वेसल्स पैराजोसिन कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स दिस मेडिकेशन विल ब्लॉक द मूवमेंट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर कैल्शियम इन टू द सेल्स एंड कॉजिंग वैसोडाइलेशन एंड डिक्रीज द हार्ट रेट वेरापामिल अल्टरनेटिव थेरेपी विच आर हेल्पफुल टू रेगुलेट ब्लड प्रेशर इंक्लूड एक्यूपंचर रिलैक्सेशन टेक्निक एंड डाइवर्जनल थेरेपी नाउ द नर्सिंग मैनेजमेंट प्रॉपर हिस्ट्री कलेक्शन शुड बी डन विच इंक्लूड फैमिली हिस्ट्री ऑल्सो डायट्री हैबिट शुड बी असेस्ड आइडेंटिफाई द मेडिकल हिस्ट्री सच एज डायबिटीज रेनल डिजीज सी ए डी instruction the patient to avoid smoking and alcoholism auscultate heart rate and palpate peripheral pulses identify the use of medicines such as contraceptive steroid when non steroidal anti inflammatory drug etc monitor vital sign frequently provide diet which is low in sodium and rich with fruit and vegetable monitor the blood cholesterol level frequently monitor the blood level frequency and hypertension of physiotherapy management is the goal of physiotherapy management complication of hypertension there is clear link clear to myocardial infarction long standing high blood pressure lead to left ventricular hypertrophy and diastolic dysfunction that cause in increased myocardial rigidity which render the myocardium less compliant and change in the preload afterload and sympathetic tone complication includes coronary artery disease hypertensive encephalopathy CAD yani coronary artery renal failure peripheral artery disease atrial fibrillation aortic aneurysm patient education recommendation the physical therapist should contribute to educating the patient to monitor and manage their blood pressure as early as childhood before it becomes a serious health problem the include of pediatric hypertension in increase as a result of the obesity epidemic diet and exercise recommended at the young age is crucial in the prevention of hypertension. When the medication are implicated, adherence is crucial in long-term management. It has been shown that approximately 50% of patients don't take medication as prescribed. According to WHO, lack of adherence is the most important cause of failure to achieve BP control. While medication adherence is important, physical activity should be equally emphasized, especially because it is primary prevention technique. Aerobic exercise is universally implemented for hypertension treatment because it's lower BP. The number first, the treatment of PT, aerobic exercise, 5 times per week 20 minutes. 5 times per week 20 minutes. Warm up 5 to 10 minutes of dynamic stretching of the entire body in order to increase heart rate. Walking on a track or treadmill for 20 minutes. Cool down 5 to 10 minutes of slow walking or gradually decrease the elevated heart rate but still keeping the muscles moving to avoid cramping. Stretching 10 minutes of variety of static stretch that engage the whole body, especially his legs. Resistance training 2 times per week after the aerobic exercise. The goal was to improve muscle endurance and techniques. Each exercise required approximately 1 minute of rest in between each set. The program was designed so that while one muscle group was resting, another could be worked by alternating the exercise in each set. Leg extension, leg curl, bench press, row, dumbbell shoulder, tricep kickback, bicep curl, abdominal crunch, side crunch, back extension, pull down stretch. Outcome: after 10 weeks of the about exercise program, demonstrate some weight loss with the BMI test showing loss of 5 kg per meter square. His cardiovascular endurance and has improved and is responsive in antihypertensive medication and increase. Discussion: study have shown that physical activities provide many health benefits. Being physically activities and fit reduce obesity related chronic disease and decrease the risk of premature death. In this case, the study demonstrated a loss of weight after 10 weeks of physical activities. The author of several systemic review have consistently reported to decrease in systolic blood pressure. मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज होते हैं, सिगरेट स्मोकिंग होता है और सेडेंटरी लाइफ स्टाइल हो गई है. ऑल आर द कॉज ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन. एंड रिलैक्सेशन टेक्निक इज द बेस्ट टेक्निक फॉर रिड्यूसिंग ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन. एंड लाइक द योगा, कपालभाति, अलोम विलोम एक्सेट्रा. एंड रनिंग इज गुड बट लाइक अ हैवी एंड फैटी पर्सन गो फॉर अ वॉक डेली टू 10 to 15 minutes. एंड कार्डियो एक्सरसाइज लाइक क्लंचिंग क्रंचिंग प्लैंक एंड एक्सेट्रा. And is one of the most important exercise of the Surya Namaskar, reduce hypertension and relax your mind. The my side of the best exercise was Surya Namaskar, yoga and cardio exercise. If in morning go for a running 10 to 8 speed. If have not a time in morning, to go for evening and walk fastly. Thank you.